welcome back to Open. Don't forget to get social with us. That's right, tweet us at BronxNet TV and tweet me too at Rhina Valentin while you're there. All right, so colorism has been a part of the African diaspora for years. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a sneak peek of this award-winning short film, Charcoal, and then we're gonna come back. Let's take a look.
My skin is black. My arms are long. My hair is woolly. My back is strong. Strong enough to take the pain inflicted again and again. What do they call me? My name is Aunt Sarah. My name is Aunt Sarah.
And welcome back to the studio. You just got a sneak peek of the short film Charcoal about colorism. And this continues to be an issue in the Black and Latino communities. And so our next guest decided to tackle this topic, hopefully to spark a conversation among younger people and or all generations to come, because it's a problem. So joining us now to talk about the film, we welcome filmmaker and photographer Francesca Andre. Hello and welcome.
Thank you, Rhina. Hello. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for being here. And thank you for making this sweet, poetic short film, because that's how it resonated with me. You used a lot of colors in your imagery, but it's really to talk about a serious topic.
Yes.
So let's talk about colorism itself and how it's impacted you.
So I was born and raised in Haiti, and my first experience, my first encounter with colorism, I was about 5 years old. I received a doll for Christmas, and when I took the doll home, all the adults started calling the doll ugly, and I just did not want to play with the doll anymore. So it's when I grew up, I realized the reason why they were calling the doll ugly, it's because the doll was different from the other dolls. It was a very dark-skinned doll. And also, just my mother wanted to send me to a Catholic school in Haiti, and I remember people telling her they may not, accept me, admit me because of my hair and because I wasn't that light. So that was like my first experience dealing with colorism. But I'm just surrounded by it. So back home in Haiti, it's not really about racism, it's colorism. It's based on your skin tone. So I decided to write Charcoal to tell that story.
Isn't that interesting within your own culture it exists?
Yes, absolutely.
Isn't that, because it's all in the mind. It's all about the way people are developing and the things that we pay attention to. Mm-hmm.
It's what we've been conditioned to believe. It's what we've been taught. And it's also from slavery, because the lighter slaves were treated differently. So after slavery, it still remains. So that's what it is, really.
Yeah, well, even as a Latina, being of the African diaspora, we deal with it as well.
Yes.
The light skin versus dark skin. And it's very fascinating. And so just share with me how you see yourself contributing to transforming that.
Okay, so Charcoal is not only about colorism, it's about women taking back their power, it's about redemption. So if you do get to see the film, you realize that at the end, when she becomes an adult, she stops the cycle of self-hatred, because colorism taught her to not fully love herself for who she is. So it's really about empowering yourself, and no matter what skin tone that you are, no matter who you are, to fully love yourself and be okay with that.
Regardless of your shape, your size, because I also noticed you used a husky young woman.
Yes.
Because that's another issue that we have is, you have to be thin, within our culture, we're voluptuous women. And not only that, that's the beauty of our world is the variety. Mm-hmm. It's all the differences, but we're talking about self-acceptance, self-love.
Yes.
As well as self-awareness, because it starts there.
Absolutely.
It starts with you understanding that you're beating yourself up.
Exactly. But, you know, sometimes children are taught self-hatred. And in Shoko, we saw that she was taught that she wasn't good enough by when she was a child. And then when she became a teenager, all this, you know, pressures from society to have lighter skin, to be accepted, to fit in. And then that goes on when she becomes an adult. So as, I guess, as older people or as adults, we also need to make sure that the messages that we are conveying in media to photography, film, print, that it's a positive message that, you know,
a positive message
encourages
diversity.
People, diversity, yes. Also encourages people to love themselves, to love who they are. But representation matters.
Absolutely.
We need to show that. That's the reason why when I was doing my casting, I wanted to cast Chengu, because she's a beautiful woman, she's a beautiful actress, she's talented. And I was very aware of her size, and I did that purposely. It was intentional.
And I'm glad you did. And I love what you captured. And I wondered, like, because I only got to see the trailer, mm-hmm. The short film itself is what, 9 minutes?
5 minutes.
5 minutes.
That's a lot in it in five minutes.
Well, it's award-winning, so I would imagine. So before we go, we still have some time. I want to know what you did to get to the place of even being able to express it in a film. Meaning, what did you do for yourself that you were able to see this and then execute it in the form of a film?
I think my process was, when I was healing, there's also this component of healing in Shoko, because for you to transform, you need to go through that process, the healing process. When I finally decided that I was gonna wear my hair natural, so I had that. But in terms of like the process, the creative process, I just, one day, it just came to me, and it was like around 4 o'clock in the morning, I just started writing it. I wrote a poem. It was a poem to honor women, you know, all women who've been through that, and not only colorism, women who've been told that they were not good enough. And I wrote it, and then I was like, you know what, I wanna make a film. So I got a little crew, and then it didn't really work out like that. So I filmed it, directed it, produced it. My husband is the editor, and I put it out there, you know, which was my gift to the world, and
beautiful.
People seem to like it. So I'm very grateful for that, and that was my process.
That was beautiful, and
thank you.
Thank you for
thank
sharing
you so
your
much.
Gifts and sharing your thoughts and sharing your intimate process, right?
Yes.
Because that's what I was getting to,
yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Because sometimes it's like we go through it, but then to put it on paper, it's like a scary process.
Yes.
And of course, to birth it and then kind of say, go, take
mm-hmm.
off.
Yeah.
And you've won some awards,
yes.
Right? And
mm-hmm.
it's still traveling. So where's it being featured now?
Okay, so the next screening is at Medgar Evers on March 24th. I'm also participating in a panel that day. By Made in NY. It's a panel of like women in film and television. I'm very happy about that. And after that, there's a screening that's coming to NYU, but I don't have the date yet. And then I have some other pending screening and festivals in Connecticut in April. Everything is on my website, francescaandrephotography.com, and then there's a page dedicated specifically for Shoko. So if you go on the site, you'll be able to find all the screening dates. And I'm also very active on social media, and people can reach out to me if they want to come, stop by, see the film.
So what's your handle on Instagram?
I think it's Francesca_Andre_photography.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah, I'm not too sure.
But they can find it on your website.
They'll find me on my website.
Yeah, no.
Yes.
I think it's lovely. I think you're lovely.
Thank you.
I love your spirit. Thank you for bringing it here.
I love yours too.
Thank you. Thank
love
you.
Love your energy. Thank
oh,
you.
Me too. And it's Women's History Month.
Yes.
And yes, sister. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. And shout out to the real sisters for bringing
yes,
me into my
you.
Space. Awesome. All right, you guys, once again, for more information on Charcoal, along with upcoming screenings, visit FrancescaAndrePhotography.com. Okay, we're taking a quick break, but when we return, we'll hear from one of New York's premier bilingual arts in education organization and Latino theater for young children. So don't go anywhere.